Okay, we're going to talk about buying things to look for when you're buying a horse trailer. There's a million horse trailers out there, and there's a lot of cheap ones and some good horse trailers. Tires, obviously, are important. Make sure it has good tires. I don't know what it is about trailers, but lug nuts tend to loosen up on trailers quicker than they do on cars. So you really want to test those, especially before you go on the road. Just make sure they're all tight. And, or run by one of the tire centers that give you the free rotation or something. Have them either rotate them or at least make sure they're torqued to the right pressure. And you don't want them coming loose, because if one nut comes off a tire, the rest of them will come off pretty quick. So, of course, you got to make sure you have good tires. Other things to look for, whether you want a 2 or a 3 horse. All the trailers out here that I can show you don't have windows. They're all open, which is called a lot of people refer to it as a stock type trailer. I like a stock type trailer because it gives a free flow of air. There was a guy who had the nice fancy trailer, loved his horses, had the best trailer, and had the windows that you can close, and it keeps the horse warm in case it gets a little cool. And he closed the windows and all 4 horses died because he didn't open the top vents, and horses take an extreme amount of oxygen to keep them alive. And he loved his horses so much to have the nicest trailer with the nice closed windows that the horses died because he didn't give them oxygen. And that's just another example of somebody who loves their horse and they really don't know what a horse needs. And they miss the basics. Clean water, grooming time, a job, exercise, shots, foot care. Those are things that horses need, not braided tails and fancy stalls and fancy windows. But anyway, I tend to go off tangents here. Let me get back to the trailers. I like stock trailers. I like good, clean airflow. If you notice on this trailer right here, the tack room is, you can move this wall, and it's a removable tack room. So the reason why I don't like these, and they tend to be cheaper, so, money kind of drives a lot of things. Somebody can reach up over there and get in your trailer and steal anything out of your tack room. Not to mention dust, dirt, bees, all kind of things. I like enclosed tack rooms. This is what's called an open tack room. But the advantages of an open tack room is I can open that panel and make this a bigger open trailer in case I want to pull everything out of my tack room and just make this kind of like a hauling trailer for 2 or 3 horses when it's really only maybe a 2-horse trailer. I could probably shove 3 horses in here. Again, don't like doing that, but sometimes you got to do what you got to do. So I like an enclosed tack room. Some people like this panel to where it's open. Again, the pros to this is somebody can climb over there. They can steal stuff in your tack room. Your tack room is secure. Dust, dirt, hay. When you're driving along, if you've got shavings in here, I don't use shavings in a trailer because I think it blows around the horse's nose, eyes, and ears. It's very bad for the horse, so I don't put shavings in my horse's trailer. Somebody will say, well, that's mean. They got to pee on themselves. You know what? I'd rather have a little splash of pee or poop instead of having shavings blowing around when I'm going 50 miles an hour on a highway and it's just blowing in their ears and eyes and getting in their respiratory system and they're trying to eat or it's getting in their throat and it dries them out. And shavings and hay and all that crap blowing around in the back of a trailer is not good. Then again, if you got the windows and you can close it up, make it all airtight, and there won't be any air back there, and then your horses will have nice shavings and it won't blow. So, and again, those are things that people get focused on. They end up hurting horses and horses pay. Well, I closed the windows so this sawdust wouldn't blow on him, and then he suffocated because there was no air. Well, you know what? You killed your horse for being stupid. I mean, I don't know which way to put it. So, but I was trying to help and the shavings was bad. So, look, don't justify what you did. There's a lot of things going on with horses. So when you get trailers, you need to realize how you're going to be loading them. If you're loading them in a winter a lot and it's cold, most people don't load a lot in the winter. They don't travel a lot in the cold. If you do, you throw a blanket on your horse. I think airflow is too important. I don't want my horse smelling his urine. I don't want him smelling the poop. I don't want shavings blowing around. And I don't want the windows closed trying to make him comfortable when his temperature is 101 degrees and you put 2 horses in a small area in a closed area. Not only does it get hot, but they can't breathe. And then they're breathing their urine and poop. So that's my pitch for stock windows. And again, this is an open tack room. I'm going to bring you over to look inside my trailer, which is a closed tack room. Again, it's a stock trailer. But if you look, mine's solid. It's a solid wall. So I can't move that. I can't open that. But my tack room stays cleaner of dust. When I shut it, it's completely closed. There's no opening.
I have an air vent because it is closed, so you can let your sweat and other things air out. You don't want to close that all the time when you put a saddle blanket or wet leathers or boots or something here. So you want to leave that cracked. This is a fiberglass roof. Fiberglass roofs are supposed to be cooler. They don't heat up like metal, so you're going to pay a little bit more. But I like a fiberglass roof. Again, it keeps the horse cooler when you're transporting them really hot or if they're in their trailer. As far as locks on trailers, all locks are keyed the same. A lot of people don't know that, but you know what? Anybody that's got an Outback has got a key to my trailer, which is why I don't lock it with a key. I lock it with a padlock, and most trailers have this option, and I put a padlock on there because this key is pretty chintzy. It's easy to pick, and if you got an expensive saddle or expensive gear and you get all your gear in there, somebody can steal it pretty easy. Now, of course, they have to get through this lock to get to mine because I have an enclosed trailer. You know, on this trailer, which is open, it's got a lock, so if you don't have a key and you don't want to mess with picking a lock, then you just reach up here and you climb over and you reach over and you get what you want out of the trailer. Another thing that I think is important is I don't like a tire on the outside. Some people like the tire on the outside because it doesn't take room out of their tack room. This means that instead of having four tires that are rotten in the sun, I have five tires. I want my spare inside. So when I get a trailer, sometimes they'll be on the side, sometimes they'll be on the front. I like a spare inside my tack room. And then, again, this is a stock type trailer, and some have these walls right here where you can hang panels on, and that way when you park your horse or you park your trailer, you can put out and make a little paddock. You can take four or five panels off and make a little square. That's kind of nice. Most people that have the panels think they rattle and they make too much noise, and they end up taking them off, just like this one. The panels aren't on here because the people that use them, they just don't use them enough to end up keeping them. So again, all these are what's called stock air. They're not windows. You want to make sure it has a good latching for the back door. I like this latch because it's got a safety, so this can't pop up. This is a common. This is going to be a little bit cheaper latch that you just kind of lift in. But I'll show you on mine. I've drilled a hole back behind here, so this can't come loose. And let's see what else I'm gonna look for. This one, of course, they've got the safety latch, so it can't come off. So that's an extra thing to make sure this doesn't come off during transport. Tie points. These tie points are welded, so they're probably not gonna break. They will break and they will bend, especially if you leave a rope tied to it and it gets wrapped around your axle and you drive off. On this trailer, my tie points are screwed on. I like having a lot of tie points. I've got three on this side and two on the other. When you buy a trailer, it normally comes with either one on each side or maybe two on one side and one on the other. So I like having a lot of tie points in case I want to either get a bunch of horses or I want to run a line or I want to use it to tie a tarp. They're just handy to have. Again, some trailers, I miss this. You notice this is a stock type trailer because it has windows, but it also has an opening in the back. I like that because it creates more airflow. Some trailers have it on the side, but there's no opening in the back. So you don't get quite as much airflow. I think you get a little bit more whistle, and I think you get a little bit more rotation of the wind in there because it's flat, and when the wind's coming in here, it's bouncing off there. So I guess I'd have to ride. I haven't rode on a highway in one of these, but you need to get in the back of a trailer and have somebody drive you down a highway if you want to know how noisy it is. Most people don't ride in the back of their trailer, so they don't really know what their horse goes through. It's very enlightening, and you really should do it. So those are different things that you want to look for. And, you know, tires, of course, are important. You make sure your trailer brakes work. And then probably the absolute most important things where I hear more horror stories is the floor. And you want to make sure you have a good floor in your trailer. This is good 2x4s. They're not rotted. They've been painted. When I replace them, I'm probably going to use the new synthetic. Because as I wash this out and rinse this out, it tends to cause a little dry rot. But you definitely want to check the floor of a trailer. Climb underneath it, make sure it's not rusted. Your wood looks good. You may get a good price on a trailer and the wood's trashy and they may end up giving away cheap and you can replace the wood. That's okay. Wood's fairly easy to replace. And you can get that new synthetic and the urine and poop doesn't rot into it and it'll last longer and it's stronger. So those are kind of the main things you want to look for in a trailer. Not sure if I missed some things, but those are the things that I look for and I think important. So, you know, price always drives it, but look around. Make sure you, when you get a trailer, you get the options you want. The thing I didn't cover is water. Some people like the water tunnels in there. I'm not a big fan of those. I usually go where places where I got water. Anyway, I'm at 10 minutes. Got to go. Hope that helps on selecting and buying trailers.